Yes, students, in the last video we discussed Bohr's atom model and Sommerfeld's atom model. Those two models, the Sommerfeld atom model, modification of Bohr's atom model. In Sommerfeld's model, the elliptical orbit was introduced by Sommerfeld for the electrons. Electrons revolve around the nucleus in the elliptical orbit. Using this Sommerfeld's that model that could explain the final structure of the atoms. But that model failed to explain certain other facts such as Zeeman effect, Stark effect. It failed to explain the distribution of electrons in different orbits. It failed to explain the intensity distribution. So in order to account for all those things, that Bohr-Sommerfeld model was again modified by Allenbeck and Goldsmith, they modified Bohr and Sommerfeld model. That model is called vector atom model. And this vector atom model is for one electron atom, atom containing only one electron. In this vector atom model, two more features are added. The features are space quantization of atoms and spinning electron hypothesis. spinning motion of electrons. These two things were added to Bohr-Sommerfeld model. What is space quantization? See, in Bohr-Sommerfeld model, the orbits of the electrons are quantized with respect to the size and shape. Their size and shape are only quantized. Size and shape of the orbits of the electrons are only quantized as per Bohr-Sommerfeld model. But when an external magnetic field is applied, it is found that the spectral lines, they split into many more lines. It is called Zeeman effect. So to explain the splitting up of the spectral lines in the presence of the external magnet field, this phenomena called space quantization, this feature space quantization is also introduced. Here space quantization, the meaning is the orientations of the orbits with respect to that applied magnet field, they are also quantized. The orientations or the directions of the orbits are also quantized. This is nothing but space quantization. Not only shape and size, along with that, the directions or orientations of the orbits are also quantized. This is space quantization. Here, the components of the orbital vector in the presence of the external field, they must be quantized by themselves. The electron orbiting around the nucleus, it possesses angular momentum, orbital angular momentum denoted as L vector. When this L vector interacts with the external magnet field of strength B, when this orbital angular momentum L is it which interacts with B, then there will be interaction of magnetic moment or the I'm sorry the electrons they possess magnetic moment during this interaction. That magnetic moment is given by EL by 2ME. This is the magnetic moment. Now quantization means space quantization means orientations are quantized, or quantization of the directions of the orbits with respect to the field direction. This is explained using a quantum number called orbital magnetic quantum number. It is denoted as ML. Orbital magnetic quantum number denoted as ML. This ML, which gives the direction of L vector, that means which gives the direction of the orientation of the orbit of the electron having the angular momentum L. Now, suppose, let us consider the example. See here, suppose the field is applied, magnetic field of strength be applied along the Z direction. The electron of orbital angular momentum L rotating about this field, this L vector rotates about this field direction. Now, the Z component of this orbital angular momentum, that is LZ, this orbital angular momentum is quantized here quantized means that should be equal to an integral multiple of h bar. So the z component of L vector is given by Lz equal to ML h bar. This is the meaning of quantization. Orbital component of orbital angular momentum in the field is quantized. This ML is called the orbital magnetic quantum number. This ML can have 2L plus 1 values. Total it can have 2L plus 1 values for a given L. What is L? Orbital quantum number. When the electron revolves in a given orbit, its level, sublevel is designated by the quantum number L. The levels are denoted as S, P, D, F and so on. And L takes the value 0, 1, 2, 3 up to N minus 1. So for a given L, ML can have 2L plus 1 values. See, for example, when L is 2, 2L plus 1 is 5. Means ML can have 5 values including 0. What are those 5 values? Starting from minus 2 to plus 2. Here L, we have taken it as 2. This L is 2. Orbital quantum number L equal to 2. Then ML can have 5 values starting from, or the values are from minus 2 to plus 2 including 0. And this is the, and these ML values, these 5 values of ML now, in this particular case, the 5 values of ML give the orientations of the orbits. How many orientations are possible for this orbit? There are 5 orientations. And all those orbits are quantized. And the orientations are given by the, represented like this. If this is the direction of the applied field, these are the orientations of the orbits corresponding to different orbital magnetic number. And the corresponding orbital magnetic moment, are 2h bar, h bar, here 0, minus h bar, minus 2h bar. So orbital angular momentum is quantized corresponding to these magnetic quantum numbers. And this is the meaning of space quantization. Space quantization, what actually it says, it describes how the plane of an orbiting electron in an atom can have a certain number of orientations. It gives the idea about the number of orientations possible and that we get from the values of ML. This is space quantization introduced by vector atom model. One more feature added is spin quantization. The electron spin concept was introduced by Goldsmith and Allen Beck in 1925. According to their hypothesis, electrons, along with their orbital motion, they possess spinning motion also. They spin about their own position, about an axis through the center of mass. So, there, because of the spinning motion, the electrons possess. See, because of the spinning motion, electrons possess spin angular momentum and they possess magnetic moment also. Magnetic moment due to spinning motion. So, according to quantum mechanics, if you consider the quantum mechanical treatment, the spin angular momentum of the spinning electron is given by S vector is square root of S into S plus 1 H bar. S is the spin quantum number. S can have only one value, but the orientation of the spinning orientation of the electron may be clockwise or anticlockwise. The spin can have two orientations, clockwise or anticlockwise. The value of S is only one. The spin value, it is given by half. The value of S is given by half. So that the spin angular momentum is given by this. It is also quantized. Now the component of this spinning motion along the direction of the magnetic field. When the field is applied, the spinning electron, its direction in the magnetic field is governed by the quantum number called magnetic quantum number. And this spinning motion is quantized so that component of the spinning motion or spin angular momentum in the direction of the field. Suppose field is applied in the z direction, component of spin angular momentum in z direction is given by Sz equal to Ms h bar. This is also quantized. Quantized means integral multiple of h bar, where this Ms is called magnetic spin quantum number. This MS can have only two values. The possible values for MS are 2s plus 1. MS can have 2s plus 1 values. S is always half, so that MS can have only two values. The values are plus half and minus half. MS can have only two values, plus half and minus half. And this is about the electron spin, and electron spin is also quantized. And using these two features, space quantization and electron spin quantization, the vector atom model, along with the features given by both Bohr and Sommerfeld, and using these two added features, this vector atom model was successful in explaining the experimentally observed facts of the spectra of atoms containing only one atom. And this is applicable to spectra of atoms containing one electron atoms. And this model was successful in explaining the spectral lines of atoms containing one electron. Now, the quantum numbers associated with vector atom model. So this vector atom model has introduced the magnetic quantum number ML, magnetic orbital quantum number ML, magnetic spin quantum number MS, along with the quantum numbers introduced by Bohr-Sommerfeld model. Now, what are the quantum numbers associated with the vector atom model? The vector atom model consists of many quantum numbers. The first one is the principal quantum number denoted as N. This principal quantum number denotes the serial number of the shells. It indicates the shells. Starting the lowest one, the innermost shell is considered as the quantum number N equal to 1. So N takes the values 1, 2, 3 and so on, excluding 0. This is about principal quantum number, the number corresponding to the main orbits or main shells. Next one is orbital quantum number L. The orbital motion of electrons represented by the quantum number L. This quantum number L indicates or represents the subshells or sublevels of the main shells or main levels, main orbits. And there in a given orbit, angular momentum of the electron is quantized, and it is given by, or it is defined as L vector. This modulus gives a magnitude, square root of L into L plus 1 h bar. The possible values of L, or L can take the values, it can have N values corresponding to the principal quantum number N. L can also have N values from 0 to N minus 1. One more quantum number is spin quantum number S. The spin quantum number defines the spin angular momentum of the electron given by this, and it has only one value, S equal to half. The next quantum number is total angular momentum quantum number. See, in this vector atom model, the basic principle considered is nothing but the total angular momentum. Total angular momentum of the atom. Total angular momentum of the atom is nothing but the combination of both orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum. It is called total angular momentum, denoted as J. And J vector equal to L vector plus S vector. Total angular momentum is the vector sum of orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum. Now, the quantum number associated with total angular momentum is J, small j, which defines the total angular momentum of the electron. So that magnitude of total angular momentum is given by this, square root of J into J plus 1 h bar. J is called the total quantum number, or total angular momentum quantum number. The value of J for one electron atom, atom containing only one electron, hydrogen or hydrogen-like atoms, the value of J is given by L plus or minus half. So that for a given value of L, J is either L plus S or L minus S. S can have value half, so that J is either L plus half or L minus half. This difference that indicates the spinning direction. In this case, spin is in the upward direction. In this case, spin is in the downward. parallel spin and anti-parallel spin. This about the total angular momentum quantum number J. Next one is the quantum number ML. So already discussed the quantum number ML. This is magnetic orbital quantum number in the presence of the applied field. Magnetic orbital quantum number, already discussed that one. Here magnetic moment is quantized. ML can have 2L plus 1 values from minus L to plus L including 0. Minus L to plus L including 0. Next is magnetic spin quantum number MS. MS can have only 2 values, plus half and minus half. The last one is magnetic total angular quantum number MJ. Magnetic total angular quantum number. As the ML and MS are clubbed, MJ is nothing but MJ plus or minus MS. MJ plus MS. That is MJ plus half or MJ minus half. But that is nothing but the total angular quantum number MJ. MJ is ML plus MS. That is ML plus half or ML minus half. And this MJ, which can have 2J plus 1 values. This MJ, what is J? L plus S. L plus S, it's always, say, half integer. Half, it is, it's a half integer value, J. So that MJ can have 2J plus 1 values excluding 0. MJ can have 2J plus 1 values excluding 0. So MJ values are from minus J to plus J. 0 is not included. Minus J to plus J. And we calculate this MJ by knowing the value of J. Say, suppose J is known. J is calculated as L plus S. When L is values for a given L, you can calculate J. For a given J, you can calculate MJ. MJ can have 2J plus 1 values. These are the different quantum numbers associated with the vector atom model. And using all these quantum numbers, this model could explain the fine structure of the spectral lines of 1 electron atoms. Atoms containing 1 electron. And this is about the atom model proposed for the atoms. With this, I stop here. Let us continue the class with another topic. Thank you.